Mike is the character that I play, and he is the estranged husband of Lucy, who's played exceptionally well by Jessica Raine, who sort of is our guide through the whole sort of crazy, beautiful labyrinth that is Devil's Hour. And you know, Mike just wants to love Lucy, but through reasons that will become very evident when you watch The Devil's Hour, there's lots of reasons why that can't be so simple as the sort of romantic notion would have you believe. And I got involved with it because I read the script, and Mike is this really complicated, dark character, and also like full of sweetness and light, and that was something that sort of drew me to it. And I worked with Tom finding those moments of lightness within it, because I think if he's just some ass, can you say ass? I don't know. If he's just a guy who's nasty the whole time, then there's nothing really we would care about. So yeah, that was important to find those bits as well.
I mean, talking about the extremes of storytelling, obviously you've got a very dark series like this, yes. And then on the other side of things, you've got an incredibly relentlessly uplifting series like Ted Lasso. Can you talk about what it is about stories at either end of that spectrum that seem to find the most special place in our heart?
I love relentlessly uplifting, like it's just it's just non-stop. I think that the core to them is that they don't exist within a vacuum. I think that horror films and thrillers that are there to scare you and terrify you, I think after a while you don't really care about. And I think with Ted, one of the things that it seems to work really well is that these are complicated, real characters in a sort of funny, silly world. And I think that, you know, we find the thrill. We like to be, you know, excited by things. We go on roller coasters, but we know it's safe, and we also know that it's within the context of our lives. We see these characters who are so brilliantly played by Peter and Jessica and Nikesh, real characters with these mad things happening to them and happening around them. And I think the same goes with Ted.
You mentioned, obviously, this character has a bit of layer and nuance to him. I'm curious, I mean, in terms of Jamie and Ted, how important you felt it was last season to have that, you know, the locker room confrontation, and to have a little bit more of a layer to Jamie than we'd previously maybe assumed.
Yeah, hugely. I mean, that was one of the great things when I first started working on it, speaking to Jason, who plays Ted, finding out what the arc is and all the little non-linear steps that he has towards sort of becoming his final form. Or, you know, whoever becomes final form, nobody does, but somewhere along that line. And again, it's about being, those layers are part of that not existing within a vacuum, because if someone was just, you know, was just an ass, that's the third time I've used that word now, I don't know if it's allowed, but then you wouldn't care. You wouldn't care about him. And so therefore, when that moment happens in the locker room, it would exist within a vacuum. And hopefully, from what the show is trying to do, it doesn't. And I think the same can be said for all the characters in that show.
Bring it back to tonight. Obviously, you can't stop with working brilliant people. I know it's a bit embarrassing when he's standing about 5 feet away from you, but can you talk about what makes Mr. Peter Capaldi one of the most electrifying and special performers that we have to offer?
I think that it's just his grasp of... I mean, listen, there's a million ways to answer that question, but the way that he understands the text, there's a lot of heavy text in this. And you can see from the trailer, even, he gets under it and it lives within him in a way that I think is a really hard skill, because it's very complicated ideas that are being sort of, that we're being taken through on Devil's Hour. And, you know, the trailer is enough. And also an incredibly, like, physically dynamic actor as well. And yeah, you know, he's also, for every moment that he has, Jessica has that toe-to-toe as well. So, yeah, it's pretty cool to be working with these lot, yeah.